G'day all, Mr. Paladin here, and today I want to do a gaming life tips with something that has been making ripples in the TF2 community. Recently, the voice actor for Soldier, Rick May, has passed away from complications due to COVID. He was already recovering from a stroke and had had other major health issues. For some people, this was their first close interaction with COVID actually hurting someone that they knew about. And everyone is handling this information in different ways. Those who have streams or make videos are doing various videos, respectfully. Across social media, we have people giving condolences or sharing any information they have about Rick while he was alive. And all of this is good, a lot of it is healthy, but some of it is being handled in a very poor fashion. Like during live streams of just about anything, people will be posting up this information as if the community doesn't already know it by now. It's been several days. I've even posted it across my Twitter, and then across streams people will be bombarding the chat with asking again and again and again, what do you think about the situation? And you know, if anyone actually follows, they would have known how I stand or what I think. Others still are starting to meme it to death. You know, we're gamers, so we have the press F to pay respects, or just posting up rip 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 all over the place, or jumping on any socially accepted bandwagon that seems to be passing by at the time. So altogether, I thought I'd do this video about death itself and how I handle anything that happens around this subject, and maybe people can glean off of that what they might want to do or how they might want to handle things appropriately. First up, important people dying should be acknowledged. I've got absolutely no problem with the community reacting to this news. Even though a lot of people did not know Rick in his life or didn't really care about what he was doing, they weren't staying up to date on his health condition. I know I wasn't. But the news of his passing is suddenly huge news to us. It's kind of like any artist where their work only becomes important after they've passed away. Suddenly their paintings are worth millions because, well, we didn't appreciate the person while they were alive, you know what I'm saying? So when the news came around of this particular passing, I only saw it offhand from Miss Moth's tweet, and I retweeted it. Then I went to find out more information just to make sure that the news was true, because you never know if there's false information out there, but there shouldn't be any reason for people to lie on this one. After that, for the next couple of days, folks were asking me if I had heard the news, even though I don't really know how more social I could be other than posting on my Twitter that I knew about the news. At first, I wasn't contemplating doing a video on the subject, because I didn't personally know Rick, so there's not much for me to say except to acknowledge that his passing had happened, appreciate his work, and let other people know who would be interested within the community. Because I'm more handling this in the way of, you know, being respectful, you know, having a time of mourning, allowing people to grieve in the way they wish to grieve about it, and then we'll move on fresh. Because, you know, death is a very real subject. I know we make light of it in games like this. I get a little counter popping up when I've killed so many people. We have bits of giblets everywhere and stuff like that. It's even kind of memed back at us in the news about how all this violence around us should be making us violent and such as that. But, you know, as gamers, we know that's not true. But death is very real. As you get older, you'll get more of it in your life. I've lost a brother. He died in a car accident. I've lost grandparents. I only have my mother's father still alive there. I've lost some very cherished pets who were part of the family. You know, all of this, you know, is personal. So if something like this happens, I can understand that the community would be sad at the news. They would want to make sure that I feel good. I've had friends and community members, when bad news has happened, circle themselves around me to make sure I'm okay. And that's perfectly fine. I fully appreciate that. That's great. But you've got to come to the realization, especially as you grow older yourself, that there's a reason that old people will check the obituary section of a newspaper. People that you know will start being there more and more and more, and it is a part of life itself. It's that whole circle of life, energy given, energy taken, you know, whatever religion you have. It's everything that is alive has to pass away at some time. We're not immortal yet on this earth, so we're gonna have to deal with this at one time. You can either ignore it right now and click away, or we can have a talk about it. Different cultures around the world have different ways to honor the dead. Everything from having specific burial rites to make sure that the dead arrive safely in the afterlife, to cannibalism in some tribes to make sure the person's energy stays with the tribe and such as that. You know, there's really, really odd cases. My wife actually had to do a study in college about how different cultures handled death, and how in one culture it would be inappropriate, whereas in another something is fully accepted. I think death of a family member is when it really hits us for the first time. When you lose a sibling, you lose a parent. I do recall when I was young, my great-grandmother had passed away. So that was my mother's mother's mother. And I was still young at the time. I just remembered I didn't much like going around to her house because it wasn't very entertaining. You know, what a spoiled brat I was. It wasn't very entertaining around her house. I'd have to find something to do. I didn't quite understand the reason for visiting was the fact that she would want to see us and such. You know, it was very a selfish time in my life. But I was young. I didn't understand. I didn't know better. You know, and I think that's where the TF2 community is right now. This is someone we know, but we're kind of being very selfish about it, and it's how it's affecting us. It's not so much, we're not thinking about him and his family, or if he has family. All I'm seeing is folks, you know, announcing the news around or memeing the situation up. Now, don't get me wrong either, some of it has been extremely respectful, like entire servers taking a moment of silence, you know, giving the 21 gun salute as what you do with soldiers. You know, kind of treating the situation almost like the forgotten soldier in Arlington. You know, America has a very big military tradition, so remembering soldiers is rather commonplace in America. And in Arlington, you have someone always standing guard over the tomb of the unknown soldier. Because we don't know all these people who have died for our rights. Just as in the same way, we don't fully appreciate all the people who have gone into making the games that we play. I know on Twitter, I end up following a bunch of voice actors these days because as I got to know them, I discovered all the works they were in. And I found out, you know, they're pretty good people. Some people don't align with me politically and stuff like that. But for the most part, having them on Twitter and seeing what they're up to, they're a pretty good sort. I highly recommend it. Look up whatever games you enjoy and see if you can't follow them on their social media. Give them a big thank you while you can. You know, before it's too late. While it's still applicable. We should celebrate the living while we can. Now back to my brother, I was actually on a trip back to see family when he passed away. I had already had a planned trip later in the year. So I missed my chance to say some final goodbyes. And that's gonna be with me forever now. So I do implore the community to do something constructive from this. Do something to celebrate the other voice actors that we have, including the other voice actor who recently voiced Soldier in the more recent videos. Let's lift each other up across the TF2 community and the gaming community, or whatever it is you play, whatever it is you enjoy, whatever artists you're into. Celebrate the life. Celebrate the fact that we're all still alive. For now. So for me personally, I remember the Meet the Soldier video. So much so that I've used voice lines from the Meet the Soldier video mimicking the soldier's voice in many videos. Like, you know who said that? Sun Tzu said that, and he knows a little bit more about anything than you do. And it depends on what I'm talking about at the time. So we'll always have that in our hearts, in our minds. The voice of soldier is set in stone for us. And we have that to celebrate. Celebrate the many people who have brought the characters that we love to life. The animators. The whole thought process on the storyboards. And then the voice actors. I especially like games these days that actually are like motion captured. So you actually see the face of the actors these days. And I think more and more that's how it's going to be. A little bit less than making a character than playing a character. So do take some time out. It is healthy to mourn the loss, to celebrate the life. And we can move on and grow from here. Without going into statistics or anything, I believe more of the community are paying, you know, pleasant respects rather than memeing it up and being disrespectful. Don't go jumping on people's live streams and spamming the news and such, because, you know, folks for the most part have already mourned. They're already moving on, or they're just keeping it in their mind whenever they pick Soldier or they play TF2. But if you're going to make this a subject matter of every stream for the next 3 weeks, 4 weeks, 5 weeks, 3 months, a year, it's going to go from being something respectful and something appreciated by the community to the community just memeing it up and making fun of someone's passing, making fun of a community member who has been a huge part of making the game what we love it to be. If you want to know what I think of the situation, well, I've got this video. If you want to share what you think about the situation, feel free to comment in this video. But commenting on other videos about it, especially something that is not TF2 related, just to bring, and how do I say this tactfully, just to bring the thought of death or the subject of death up in a different stream is probably not cool. You know, I had a video recently where I was celebrating something, but because of this recent news, people wanted only to know about the death and what we thought of the death and stuff like that. So it was difficult to celebrate this happy moment in my life because people didn't even look to see if I had already talked about this, if I hadn't already posted the news on Twitter several days ago. I understand people aren't stalking me, they're not going to check all my stuff all the time, but you can assume that all the major TF2 members know about this particular passing. Go ahead and check their channels, see if they've done something up to see how they feel. Thanks for watching, I hope this helps you in your future endeavors, and I hope you live long and have a happy life.